Okay, let's talk about tabular data. You're probably familiar with spreadsheet applications like Microsoft Office's Excel or Calc from Apache OpenOffice or even Google Spreadsheets. So with any one of these applications, we can create tabular data in the form of a spreadsheet. So I'm a big Beatles fan. Indulge me as we begin a little data wrangling with some discography data. After all, I'm sure even space cowboys will be listening to the Beatles someday. Okay, so as data scientists, we're usually concerned with what items a data set contains and what fields those items have. As I'm sure you're aware, with tabular data, each row represents a data item, and an individual item can have one or more fields. The columns each represent a different field, and in most tabular data, the very first row will actually label those fields in some way. Finally, we have an individual cell that contains a value for a particular field. In this case, the label for this particular album is Capitol Records in Canada. Okay, so just to look at that again in a more abstract sense, each row is an item in our data set. Each column makes up the fields for the data items. And finally, individual values for a field are stored in cells. In the videos that follow, we'll quickly get our hands dirty working with tabular data in the CSV and Excel data formats in the Python programming language.